Good evening, everyone. This is A4UR8 back again with you on my channel with another very special video for your viewing and listening pleasures. And at this time, I'm going to pay tribute to a very special young woman. This video is dedicated to the memory of my cousin, Miss Tynera Monroe, who passed away on November 29th, 2017. After a long, courageous battle with diabetes at the all-too-soon age of 27. In her memory, I will be performing a song entitled Calling Your Name Again by music legend Richard Carpenter. So, Nera, this one's for you, cuz you are forever loved and missed. Rest in peace. I wake up in the dark. Silence brings me to my senses. I wonder where you are. Then I feel the pain in my heart. 'Cause I'm living without your love. And I'm all alone for the first time. And it doesn't seem to be a dream that will be over. All the words you said weren't enough to fool this heartache. Memories in my head aren't enough to stop me falling apart. 'Cause I'm living without your love. Maybe it won't be the last time. I don't know how much more I can take. Hopeless, wide awake, and here I go. Calling your name again. Thinking of all that we two had before. There's got to be more, this I know. Calling your name again. Remembering all the love you gave to me and how it used to be. I think of what's to come. Then I turn and see your picture. The tears begin to fall. And soon I can't make sense of nothing at all. 'Cause I'm living without your love. Don't think that I'll make it this time. Something tells me this is not the end. I wish I could pretend, but here I go. Calling your name again. Thinking of all that we two had before. There's got to be more, this I know. Calling your name again. Remembering all the love you gave to me. And how it used to be. Here I go, calling your name again, remembering all the love you gave to me, and how it used to be. How it used to be. Mm-hmm. Well, I hope you all enjoyed my interpretation of that beautiful song. And please remember to leave your comments. They are always welcomed, encouraged, and appreciated. And before I sign off, I'd like to take a minute to send my love to Tynera's mother, my cousin Stephanie, my cousins Gerald and Gerald Jr., her brother and father, respectively, or Gerald Sr., my mistake, excuse me, her younger brother Jeremiah, her aunt Erica, and a host of other family members and friends. Tynera, to me, was a beautiful soul inside and out. If you were good to her, she was good to you. But if you crossed her, watch out. She would do anything for anybody. And I ought to know. Because I had the good fortune of spending 3 decades with her, the first 30 years of my life with her. And we always had fun. We always had so much fun together. And just the sight of her, when we were having family functions, she would walk up and in that signature voice, she would say, "What's up, big cuz? Hey, Nera, how you doing, baby?" would be my typical response before we hugged. But then the diabetes started to set in, and it was particularly bad going into 2017, the late part of 2017. I got a call from my mom about Tynera, and she gave me the heartbreaking news that Tynera was gone. And if that wasn't bad enough, her passing came just 2 days shy of my 31st birthday, which pretty much put a damper on my birthday plans that year. But knowing Tynera the way I did, she would want me to celebrate even if she was there physically or not. So to close this out, I'll just say, so long, Nera. We're all so grateful for the years we had with you. And my God, how we loved you. And that love will live forever. And so will you. You're in the arms of the angels now, babe. I love you. I'll always love you. And I'll always treasure the times we had. Rest in peace, baby girl. Until again. So long, everybody.